Hello. In this CMMI Tech Talk series, we are sharing a brief overview of specific practice areas. In this video, we will look at one of the new practice areas in the CMMI model, data management. You will see the key features of the practice area while we explore what they mean for both users of the CMMI and appraisal teams. This practice area is one of two in the managing data capability area as part of the enabling category. Looking at the intent and value statements of this practice area, we find the following. Intent identifies, implements, and controls the approach and activities for managing data. Value maximizes operational efficiency by prioritizing critical data activities to meet performance needs. We can see straight away from these statements that the practices of the data management practice area have a proactive component. For example, identifying, implementing, and controlling an approach implies planning to achieve some goal. The nature of this goal is revealed in the value statement. We want to look after our critical data so that our ability to achieve business goals and performance needs is maximized. Thus, what constitutes critical data is largely determined by its impact on the organization's ability to conduct its mission. Why the focus on critical data activities? Because all businesses have a finite amount of time and resources. A few pitfalls to watch out for when leveraging these best practices in your organization is 1, do not treat all your data the same. 2, ensure you create an appropriate balance between the value of the data and controls you place upon it. For example, data personal to you includes your social security number, birthday, address, cell phone number. Some of this information, like your social security number, is critical and requires strict controls, whereas you may typically share your address and phone number with all your family and friends. Similar to how we value and interpret our personal data, organizations must also evaluate the level of control and criticality of their data. Looking at the practice summary table, we see that the practices of data management contain the same evolutionary development of capability as you would expect. The level 1 practices are relatively rudimentary in nature, while the level 2 practices build sound managerial principles, and level 3 extends this to an organizational perspective. Let's take a closer look at some of these practices. Practice DM 1.1 looks to identify the data management objectives. Of course, level 1 behavior is relatively unsophisticated, but it is important to realize that this practice formulates a foundation for all the other practices. It is establishing the foundation for why is data management important to us? What are we trying to achieve? So even though at level 1 the objectives may be relatively simple, determining the basics of what we are doing in this area is important and will establish context for the structure and complexity of the data management activities. It is natural for an organization's maturity and capability with data management activities to evolve as the organization proceeds through the practice group levels. But even at a basic level, at level 1, we are likely to be interested in maintaining the security and confidentiality of important data items, as well as making sure they are available when we need it. Looking at DM 1.2, you might think initially that using metadata to manage data appears a little complex for a level 1 practice. However, the concept of metadata is fundamental for data management. The first sentence of the additional explanatory information provides an insight into the role metadata plays. Think of metadata as characteristics of the data, like the data value of New York can be classified as a city and part of a geographic location or address. It states, metadata is a category of information that identifies, describes, explains, categorizes, and provides content, context, structure, and classifications pertaining to relevant data assets, and it enables effective retrieval, usage, and management of these assets. In other words, understanding the value and impact of our data is a necessary first step before we can define the metadata to help support its usage. Metadata may evolve over time, and while at level one, the metadata is likely to be relatively simple, this should only be seen as an initial starting point. The level two practices build upon this initial position. Practice 2.1 is important in introducing a data management approach. Essentially, this is seeking to develop processes and plans for conducting the data management activities. Notice in the additional explanatory information that it is recommended to review the data management approach against configuration management activities, plans, and processes. While data management and configuration management are related to each other, they are also distinct and both plans are needed. While configuration management is important in maintaining the integrity of work products, data management also addresses how the data is structured, manipulated, and developed over time. Organizations gain synergies by looking at configuration management and data management business needs together, such as requirements for tools and reporting. The detail of practice DM 2.2 may be important in developing this data management approach. It describes establishing a data management architecture that supports the data management approach. There is a very useful list of things to consider in this regard for the first line of the example's activities in this practice. The essential substance of building an effective data management capability is covered in these four practices at level one and level two. So it is important to get this right at a basic level and then evolve the capability. The level three practices are instrumental in helping this evolution. To this point, we may have effective but isolated data management approaches. Practice 3.1 advocates the establishment of an organizational function that oversees the achievement of organizational-wide data management objectives. The additional explanatory information for this practice provides an informative list of things that may be included in the remit of this function. Do not see this list as an exhaustive checklist, but rather as a guide. The specific nature of the organizational function depends heavily on the organization's data management objectives and priorities. It is a reasonable assumption that multiple data management plans may exist in the organization. There may be an organizational level plan addressing the activities of the organizational function, as well as project or service group data management plans that take their lead from the organizational level plans while articulating the specific data management approach for a relevant group. Practice 3.2 deals with a topic that is a common theme at level three, learning lessons. The practice discusses reviewing the effectiveness of the organization's data management program and then acting accordingly based on this review. Effectiveness implies that we can measure what is going on with our data management activities. This in turn requires that our data management objectives are stated in SMART terms. So the overall key to this practice area can be summarized in terms of clear data management objectives, understand the nature of the data being managed and utilize that information to define the right metadata. Develop a comprehensive data management approach that considers the business drivers and accompanying value of the data to the business. Leverage a data management architecture to provide a framework for the data management approach. Periodically evaluate the effectiveness of the data management program and take action when needed for improvements. Thank you for joining us for this CMMI Tech Talk. If you have questions, please contact us at support.isaca.org.